fantastic, can determine what happens to our BlizzCon bracket, which we will reveal at the end of the day. The gates are now open.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the grand finals. This is the last time you're going to see these teams go head-to-head until BlizzCon, the world finals. Nixie in trouble, dips low, trades out, die by the sword to recover. At this point, though, XRB have established dominance. That is the most powerful defensive cooldown on Tempo Storm's side, forced out in a matter of seconds.
Yeah, and the Cyclones coming in to follow it up from Looney. Excellent turbo play by all three members of XRB to the moon, showing why they've won multiple tournaments running this composition, Tempo Storm. This is the first grand finals they've reached in 2018. Botar on their roster has already shown to be the best thing that could have happened to Tempo Storm this year, and still, it's a brave call to go up in the mirror against XRB playing the turbo.
This is XRB to the moon's lawn. This is the turbo cleave lawn, and Tempo Storm are trying to intrude on that lawn in a mirror. This is a dangerous move to make. They've tried to steal some of the strategies that XRB used earlier by switching to Looney, but they're not doing it nearly as effectively. They're falling behind on mana, they're falling behind on cooldowns, and they're falling behind on pressure consistently through this. And XRB to the moon, their experience and time spent on this composition is starting to show itself here. Tempo Storm need a surprise kill at this point to be able to etch a win.
Yeah, Tempo Storm intrude on the lawn, but if there's one thing we know about Blizzard and ZPI is they will mow you down if you get in their way. Botar now caught up in the Storm Bar, already down to about half of his blue bar, his mana pool. He's not going to be able to keep this up forever. Nixie doesn't have Die by the Sword, doesn't have Trinket, dying through heals at this moment in time. Said Tempo Storm really struggling going into game one.
Reason Looney's ahead on mana, he paired that Innervate with Tree of Life. Botar didn't make that same trade. It lost him a lot more mana on his Tree of Life. Even just a simple mistake on that Innervate gives an advantage now to XRB to the moon. You cannot afford to make any errors in such a high-pressure matchup. Both Warriors and Enhancement Shamans just do so much damage. The Druids are pinned down, making hard decision after hard decision to stay in the fight. XRB set up good crowd control and a swap to Jamie. That banks them an Astral Shift. Now both Jamie and Nixie are vulnerable. Botar has to make a difficult decision. Who does he commit the Iron Bark on? If he uses it on Nixie, they can just switch to Jamie. He commits it to Nixie. They switch their attention to Jamie. He's going to be under immense pressure moving forward.
Looney's actually playing with the Cyclone, and he's been getting some fantastic ones. Botar is not even running the Honor Talent Cyclone, so there's nothing for ZPI to worry about, nothing for Looney to worry about as he pushes in, gets the Mighty Bash pressure in favor of XRB to the moon. We see a good Ursul's Vortex, though, going to deny some of that damage. Tempo Storm are starting to get back into the game, but the mana lead still heavily in favor of Looney on that Restoration Druid. He can keep this going for much, much longer in this situation.
Looney locked down and winch your Stormbolt crowd control chain, but he iron barked right before it. Nice read by Looney. Jamie is the one who's just falling behind slowly but surely. Is he gonna be able to stay in the fight? Right now, there's no clear openings. Maybe ZPI dying in a Stormbolt. That's the only move I see right now for Tempo Storm. The win condition is Wind Shear Looney, Stormbolt ZPI, 100 OM. Other than that, I don't see an opening. XRB to the moon know that they're not vulnerable. They can get a little bit more cheeky. They can get aggressive and go after Botar, try and expend more mana, applying Rejuvenation to all three targets rather than two. Tree of Life been forced once again, but he didn't pair it with Innervate. This is just gonna cost him even more mana to recover.
It's really starting to be trouble time for Tempo Storm, and I really like the swaps coming out of XRB to the moon in the mirror. Whenever they can catch Botar out, they even when Tempo Storm come back, it's like triple cleave damage. They're hitting Botar and the melee DPS, so it's just far more effective, far more efficient for XRB to the moon. We see Looney pushing in, maybe looking for a Mighty Bash, kiting away from Nixie, taking zero damage from that swap. He's even restored some of his mana going into dampening here. We see another Storm Bolt, Ascendant. ZPI is the only Shaman running that Ascendance, but a good fair shutdown from Nixie denies a lot of that incoming damage.
Yeah, ZPI activated that stone form and he got punished with an intimidating shout. That was well done by Nixie. It denied a lot of burst damage from ZPI. We see Blizzo disarmed. Looney Stormbolted. Good crowd control initiation. Ooh. By Tempo Storm. And Blizzo trades. Very close call, as well as Nixie. I mean, at any point, these Warriors could just crumble to the pressure. There's so much damage on both sides. Botar's mistimed Innervate has cost him so much mana, though, in this game. And triple crowd control by XRB. Great execution. Jamie dips low, trades Astral Shift, but Looney keeps the chain going. Oh, the Cyclone on Botar. This is going to cost him even more mana. Finally, Tempo Storm striking back. Pressure on ZPI and Blizzo. Looney trades up, but look, Innervate, Tree of Life, exact same time. time, all of these spells are free. His mana is going to stay massively ahead, and as we get closer to dampening, the healing is going to become even more restricted. It's going to cost more mana, and with that lead, XRB to the Moon should be securing victory shortly.
I mean, it really feels like either of these warriors could die by the sword here. Nixie, though, caught up in the disarm, dropping low damage from both fronts of XRB to the Moon, who are definitely taking that mana lead. And Looney, he's expending his mana happily, knowing he has that advantage. That's one of the reasons that this is so big for the team. He could do whatever he wants in this situation, getting out Cyclones, denying incoming damage, forcing trinkets left, right, and center. Meanwhile, Botar, almost out of mana, having to play efficient. Jamie dropping low. Nixie dropping low. Beautiful purge coming in from Zpie, denying that free healing. Nixie dropping low, almost in tactical range. He might fall here.
Both warriors low, but Looney goes for a clone. Jamie trinkets. He gets cloned again. These cyclones by Looney, keeping Blizzo alive in that close call situation. Even at 6% dampening, Looney's mana lead is almost gone, but Jamie's low. Winter on Botar. He pre-iron barked in. He gets Stormbolt on the follow-up. Looney jumps in to cross crowd control. Great play by Looney. He was winning the long game. He was winning the exchange. All around, Looney just had a massive lead that slowly showed itself moving into dampening. Execute for kills. So XRB to the Moon not only bring perfect defense, they now bring execution into their strategies. And with that together, I don't know if anyone can stop them.
And also, the other thing that you have to think about is XRB, like you said, they were that team to dampen a lot. And we always criticize teams for playing to their strategy. Now we see TempoStorm playing to XRB's current strategy. That is a terrifying thing to do against one of the best teams in the world.
And I already like this adaptation coming in from XRB to the Moon. Sit on top of Botar, get that cleave damage, the Restoration Shaman, not as mobile as the Restoration Druid. So that's definitely one of the weaknesses Botar's going to have to contend with in this game, as we see Stormbolt Trinket already forced out, Earthenwall Totem already down, double capstone, great opener for XRB.
XRB are dominating right now, really putting Botar on the back foot. He's opted to reposition away from the bot, actually running back to them, but he's just getting cleaved. Botar is playing the Restoration Shaman for a late game. He's doing the play to live strategy, trying to win off mana. XRB to the Moon know that, so they're just running at him, putting the gas pedal straight down through the floor, running him down. Cyclones by Looney, this is what I mean. This is a completely different XRB to the Moon. We have not seen them play like this throughout the entire year. Now they bring their unbreakable defense with insane offense. Look at the pressure. The entire team is dead, Adrian.
Yeah, I mean, this is XRB playing Turbo Cleave. They're just the best at it. They know every single in and out of this matchup, and they are looking fantastic. Botar trades out the Spirit Link, but it won't do anything, Sid. All three members dying. He's struggling so much. No defensive cooldowns remaining. Tempo Storm are very close to losing this game.
They do have good counter pressure, but they need to stay alive a bit longer. Both healers Storm bolted. Botar in more trouble, hangs on by a thread, trying to duck away from the executes of Blizzo, but he actually runs right back to him. Blizzo gets disarmed. He's going to pause the game out. Triple Sunder by Jamie. Nice move there. It's into the double cap totem. Jamie swinging the game back in his team's favor, but now Zpie reverses with a Sunder of his own. Looney's windshield, but everybody in this game could die at any second. Jamie's in execute range. He is going to fall first. XRB to the Moon say, no way. You're not going to play the late game. We're going to chop you up before you're going to even...
can happen in the remaining series. Throughout the day, BlizzCon can be affected, and XRB can find themselves on match point.
Tempo Storm tried to beat XRB to the Moon at their own game, mirroring them in game one and then making a slight adaptation in game two, but you're not going to beat XRB to the Moon in their own home court. Now, Tempo Storm going back to a mage rogue composition, they're trying to take into consideration what worked the best for them overall. The Priest wasn't working because he was getting rushed down, so let's have Botar play Druid. The Windwalker wasn't really working down. It doesn't bring as much surprise pressure, so let's just bring in the Outlaw Rogue instead. So Tempo Storm have really assessed what was working the best, and let's just combine them together and see how it works. They've still got a couple games. They're not on match point yet, as the finals is a best of seven. They've got good crowd control right now on Looney, putting Zpie behind. They've managed to force Astral Shift. Botar with a nice Cyclone at low health. Then they switch to Blizzo, trying to get that multi-target pressure against a Druid, force Looney to make a mistake. Tempo Storm start this game off strong.
They started off strong, but I mean, the only cooldown they really forced there was the Astral Shift. They didn't force Trinket on Zpie or Blizzo, and they committed the blind for that. So I actually think it's a pretty reasonable trade for for XRB to the moon. And it's kind of similar to what I said. You lose some of the offense when you don't have a Disciplined Priest. You lose some of that just raw damage. You lose the fear, obviously. The low Cyclone's great, but as soon as Zipai's out of that Cyclone, there's no stun DR. He's just able to top himself off with those healing surges, even if you cross control Looney there. So I'm not 100% sure on that. I think it is a good start for them, but more just because the fact that Tempo Storm knows they have to kind of play into the long game, and the Outlaw's going to provide the utility to get them there.
Ouch, that gouge 1 second too late, and they were not able to follow up the crowd control chain. Alec got denied on that attempt, which is going to put them another setup behind. And Tempo Storm have been playing much more aggressively than I would have expected. Now Nixie, we see doing what we saw Waz do in the first cup of this season, where he just pulls away, lets the Frost Mage snare up the entire team till they have those stuns, then they push in. Right now, Botar getting swapped to XRB, trying to push the issue, forcing his hand, all of his defensive cooldowns at that point. He's got not a lot to work with if they can connect again, and they've got a minute and 40 seconds to do it. XRB to the moon. Man, this is probably the most improved team, I think, throughout the year. Their defense looked flawless at the start of this year, but we always criticized them on their offense and their setups. They were lacking in that regard. Nice read by Zipai. He pre-astral shifts the incoming attack during the blind sap. Zipai could have been eradicated in that position, but he's just in their heads. He read that situation perfectly and denies a kill. Tempo Storm, what can they do?
I mean, this is the thing. When you play against a player as good as Zipai, you get the blind, you have to wait a global for the stun, and Zipai has already reacted in that time. If they do the stun first, then Looney will react with the Iron Bark. This team always on the ball, always paying attention to what their opponents are doing, and like you say, reading them like a book there. We also saw Blizzo contributing the War Banner on the sap, denying the crowd control chain even further. And this is what makes XRB such a good team, and they find the offensive opportunities, as you were also talking about. Botar without a trinket now, they can get another swap over onto him. Unfortunately, they won't have the ascendance for it, since they committed that in the opener to force that trinket. But now it's just kind of both the teams resetting a little bit. No one really has any major offensive cooldowns, though. Maybe Alec will try and catch Zipai out in the middle. It could be a great opportunity for them, since he doesn't have the astral shift.
We're in the middle of a best of seven grand finals Europe's region, with two teams that have the most to prove. Tempo Storm's performance throughout the year has been lackluster at best. They decided to make the move and replacement Boyke with Botar. It's managed to get them to the finals, but they might be hitting a brick wall. XRB to the moon have rounded out their strategies to not only bring unbreakable defense, but insane offense and setups as well. And at this point, Tempo Storm, I think, are going to need a miracle. Botar's been getting cheeky, making these stealth plays that allowed him to sneak in range and get a stun before being crowd controlled himself. That's top level druid play. Botar's back. He's ready to make his name really show what it means moving towards BlizzCon, but they've only got two more games to work with. If XRB can just close this out, it might just be a clean sweep.
Yeah, I mean, it's looking very much like that. We'll have to see how the game does change going into dampening, but so far Looney's look very comfortable. Every single time you see that frozen orb combined with the ice form from Alec, there's always an Iron Bark to answer on him. And I mean, there they did a swap to Blizzo. Once again, Iron Bark comes out completely fine. We see Avatar committed now. They're going after Nixie. Like I said, he is a bit of an exposed target, though he has a few more defensive cooldowns and utilities, kiting, etc., playing that Outlaw specialization.
Tempo Storm trying to play for dampening. They've been focusing on defense, 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 but you're going defense head-to-head against XRB to the moon. That's what they were known for the entire year. I don't know if it's going to work out for them. We're going to have to wait and see. As Dampening has finally entered the arena, it's going to be reducing the effectiveness of all incoming heals. It's going to force healers to trade cooldowns in situations that they otherwise wouldn't, or potentially just go down through the defense because they simply can't heal anymore. Things are going to get more and more intense. Tempo Storm are the ones who are trying to play for Dampening. They want it as high as possible, build up a massive wave of damage, hit XRB to the moon all at once when they can't recover. It's up to XRB to rush Tempo Storm down before they can reach critical mass.
I mean, XRB to the moon, their Tempo Storm made a little bit of a blunder. I think Nixie blinded into the War Banner, either that or still DR from the Cyclone coming in from Botar. Either way, that's another offensive push mitigated. XRB to the moon now looking to get aggressive on their own. We see Zipai constantly going for those hexes, and that's another fantastic thing the Shamans can do. They can just look for hexes, be annoying, shut down the mage, something that ZPI, of all people, is exceedingly good at, and just tunnel down Nixie in this situation, dampening those starting to stack. And this is where the question will really come. You can see even Botar spamming out those solo rafts. They're just trying to kind of test the waters here. How much damage can Looney truly heal through? He has the full mana pool, but he has to perfectly estimate this damage every single time, because if he over or under reacts, it could just be game.
Well-timed drink there by Looney. So Looney realized that this is going to be going for a long game. He was losing on mana, so he decided to kind of duck out of the fight for a second, sit down for a drink, regenerate mana back to full so he can be at the same capacity as Botar as we move deeper into Dampening, where things become increasingly stressful for both teams. You can see that Looney and Botar are playing on opposite ends of the map from each other. They don't want to risk getting crowd control, but Tempo Storm pulled the trigger. This setup, ZPI read the situation again, and Astral shifted right before that crowd control was initiated. I don't know if ZPI is a shaman or a mind reader. Is he a priest? I don't know, because right now it's impossible for Tempo Storm to get through that. If every single time ZPI reads a situation, it's not looking too good. At the same time, XRB, they need to start getting on target. They've managed to force Botar's Tree of Life. He's not going to have that big bounce back recovery for another 3 minutes. In that window, they need to work down the gladiator medallions of either Botar or Nixie. I would like to see some swapping from XRB to the moon. They're really just hammering down on one target. I think attacking Nixie while walking towards another target is their best option. That way they're more likely to force a mistake, land a stun in a less defensive position, and force the gladiator's medallion to remove that stun, and then later have that option with it not available. This bash on Nixie has forced Botar to use Iron Bark, one defensive cooldown out of the way. As Dampening ramps up, that cooldown is less effective. You can say that, see, that's already starting to sink in as Nixie isn't fully recovering through that situation. Botar spending more mana now to recover. Alec pulls the trigger on Ice Form. He's just going to go for raw pressure. Ebb and Bolt Flurry swaps that over to Blizzo, realizing that Iron Bark was used on ZPI. And Tempo Storm, the way they win this is with multi-target pressure. Attacking one, force a cooldown, swap targets, attack the other one, burst it down as quickly as possible. If Tempo Storm initiate that kind of setup deeper into Dampening, they could put a point on the board.
Yeah, that's absolutely right. And that's one of the reasons I'd actually like to see Alec saving a little bit more of that burst, because at the start as the Frost Mage, he's actually going for the Frozen Orb immediately on the swap, which is kind of prompting either the Astral Shift or the Iron Bark. And he's also committing Comet Storm and kind of like all his burst. We see another War Banner there, narrowly missing out on the Blind from Blizzo. Good attempt though. We see ZPI once again preemptively gets the Astral Shift down, but because they forced that defensive cooldown, now Alec should be saving a lot of his damage to kind of swap it over to Blizzo without those damage mitigating cooldowns. It's something that I'd love to see them going for more and more, but once again, the cooldowns come out, traded by ZPI, and I mean, we've got to commend ZPI here, because every single time, within that one kind of second gap, there's a Blind. You have 1 second on that global before Nixie, and he's always getting the Astral Shift up. If it was the other way around, the Iron Bug would come out from Looney, and they're using the space to their advantage. This was Tempo Storm's map pick.
Yeah, three times in a row, ZPI shuts Tempo Storm down. Tempo Storm are just going to rely on that massive wave of damage deep into Dampening to get a kill, because otherwise, they can't get through the defense of XRB to the moon. They're playing flawlessly at this point. And Tempo Storm have set themselves up for the late game. They've still got all their Gladiator's Medallions. They still have a lot of defensive cooldowns. And the way they're going to use those cooldowns is to buffer themselves for a big push. So to make themselves more durable, stand in the face of XRB, and then push them over with damage and deep Dampening. And they've set themselves up perfectly for that situation. At this point, it's actually looking better and better for Tempo Storm. It's up to XRB to find an opening, but on Tolvaron Arena, they can't so easily gun down Botar. He can just play very far away and avoid damage and overextend them. And if Blizzo makes even one mistake on his positioning, he could get erased by Alec. Right now, they've locked Blizzo down as Looney was looking for a drink. Looney jumps in, bashes Alec, managed to get the human racial. Alec blinks out a range of Cyclone. Looney shapeshifts the Poly to avoid it. Looney really wants to go for the Cyclone. He gets it on Alec. These Cyclones from Looney could be game-breaking into Dampening. Looney has to be the setup for his team. If he can get some Cyclones on Botar, they've managed to force Nixie's defensive lineup. They've gotten through the Tree of Life. Tempo Storm are starting to crack a bit here. They're almost at critical mass. They just need to make it a little bit longer, but Looney could be the X factor for XRB to turn this game in their favor.
Yeah, we've hit that point of Dampening now. We're about, I think, 11 minutes into the game, 36% Dampening, where it's going to be really hard for both of these healers. The fact that Botar traded out that Tree of Life there is huge, because that is the massive incoming healing cooldown that he is opting for. for, rather than a talent choice like Looney with the cultivation, which is a little bit more overall healing. So Botar now going to be basically losing out on that benefit for the rest of the game.
He did it again!
All blind, coming out onto Looney once again, though, answered by the Astral Shift on ZPI. But, I mean, at the same time, every single outplay ZXRB are doing, we talked about the offensive gameplay, they're really struggling to get anything going. Trinket still available for Nixie and Botar. Damage constantly crashing in from Alec. I actually still get the edge to Tempo Storm in this game.
But there are signs of life with Nixie burning through that riposte. He can't activate that to parry attacks, which is really effective against two melee classes. They have to rely on Iron Bark. But in Deep Dampening, that cooldown's not as effective. Nixie trades Faint as Botar is crowd control. Alec is supporting. Good teamwork on Tempo Storm's part. They are still not at that critical wave point yet. If ZPI was bowling, he's pretty much played a perfect game every single time. He gets that Astral Shift nailed down with the blind, which is important because with Blinding Powder, it's a minute and a half cooldown. Astral Shift as well, but ZPI has to outplay the situation to survive it. And he's done it, I think, 5 times in a row. Any other Shaman would not be doing this, and it's not leaving any openings for Tempo Storm, which is why we're getting to such excessive levels of dampening. I'm not sure if they have the damage to push ZPI over, and now, luckily for Tempo Storm, Riposte is becoming available. They're posturing themselves again in a good position, but they need to hammer down on a big push at some point into this match, or potentially Nixie could get taken out.
But we talk about all these plays from XRB to the moon. I'm just starting to wonder if it actually matters. Like, where is the opening? It doesn't seem like there is one. They can't kill Alec. He's a Frost Mage kiting away. They can't kill Botar because he's max ranging, utilizing this massive map. And Nixie, who could potentially be the kill target, if you're a melee right now, you're running one of these melees that has a lot of mobility, such as the Feral, such as the Windwalker, such as this Outlaw Rogue, you should just watch what Nixie's doing. Every single time he has his stuns up, as we see a beautiful Vortex coming in, he's going for the kill. But whenever they don't have pressure, he's just using that mobility, kiting away, denying any opening for XRB, and 48% dampening in. It's Looney who's falling behind.
So ZPI went for that preemptive play. Tempo Storm predicted it and went on a different target, which baited ZPI to use a defensive in a situation that he didn't need to. They managed to bank Blizzo's defensive and also now split pressure on ZPI. That split pressure against a Druid is exactly what Tempo Storm need to win. We are getting to insane levels of dampening, 50% reduction of healing. Both Druids maintaining their mana with drinks throughout this. They know that they're trying to play it out for any critical mass point. But at this point, Blizzo and ZPI are both vulnerable. Looney has to make a hard decision on where to use his Iron Bark if he uses it on ZPI. Tempo Storm switch their aim to Blizzo and can push him over. Alec has Ice Form in 7 seconds. Adrenaline Rush popped. Tempo Storm are trying to finally push XRB to the moon over. Nixie gets Storm Bolted though, looking to reverse pressure. Botar in position to deny it, mashing out Regrowth. There's the stun. Alec is spamming up Polymorphs to try and catch Looney, but he has not caught Looney once with these cheeky Polymorph attempts. XRB to the moon have played perfect defense in this game, but even despite that, Tempo Storm have crafted a strategy that it may not just matter. These hexes on Alec could be an opening if they can get hex on Alec. That allows Looney to move in, but there's the blind. ZPI trades Trinket. We're at such high dampening points that you have to trade cooldowns. You can't be greedy anymore. If you are, you're just simply gonna fall over. Blizzo doesn't have much. Looney denies the kill. They disarm Nixie, but he activates that riposte. He's gonna stay in the fight. Looney moves in. He gets Botar's Trinket, but now Botar Trinkets and reverses with a bash of his own, and Blizzo is all alone in center field with tons of damage flying at him. Tempo Storm looking to close this out, but Blizzo still denies it with an intimidating shout onto two members. XRB stay in the fight, fighting valiantly to the bitter end, but critical mass, it has to be soon.
I mean, maybe Tempo Storm made the error here. They don't have any defensives for Nixie, no trinket on him. Botar, no trinket, no Ironbark, no riposte. This could be the opening XRB have been waiting about 15 minutes for. Botar
Looney
and Nixie are both exposed at this moment in time, though dampening at critical mass. ZPI might just die to raw damage coming out of Tempo Storm. Ironbark in the nick of time. Will it be enough, though? Do they have the Storm Bolt for Nixie? He has his trinket available. Once again, I wonder if the opening has disappeared for XRB to the moon. They're trying to connect over to Botar, but there's no trinket on Blizzo. There's no trinket on ZPI. This next stun from Nixie could well be the game.
I mean, at this point, Tempo Storm, if you're not going to win at 64% dampening, when are you going to win? Blizzo, he's in a 3-on-2. Looney's still crowd control, but Nixie Pixie! Is he actually gonna go down? He barely survives. Botar saves him. Blind on Looney. Z-Pi's got basically nothing to work with. That's such deep dampening. They commit the stun, but he pre-astral shifts. Blizzo is hiding for his lives. XRB are quivering. They played a perfect defense, but there's been no openings for them to find a kill. Really, it's Nixie. He's the one that needs to not throw the game. He should just rely on Alex pressure. And it's exactly what he's doing. He pulls away to bait Blizzo to chase him down. They have to go for it. They've got nothing left. We're getting to the highest dampening I think we've ever seen in the history of the game at this point. Blizzo's just hovering at 30%, trying to do whatever he can to stay alive, but Botar's got Tree of Life. There's almost no possibility that they can kill through that defense. Blizzo leaps and he fears it. They've got 5 seconds to kill Nixie. 1 second left to kill Nixie. Are they going to be able to do this? No way. Tempo Storm have been playing for this critical mass, but it's slowly turned maybe in XRB's favor as defense is blown completely out on both sides.
Botar's actually run out of mana at this point. This is the trouble. Nixie either needs to go for a full reset here and completely disappear from the map, and he will do that with the Vanish. This is the opportunity for Botar to drink. Love this play from Nixie. Clean Vanish behind the pillar. Botar drinking. Full reset for Tempo Storm. Surely this will be game. Alec will, of course, have those blizzards, have those frozen orbs, and he's completely safe. Hasn't used an ice block the entire game. He can push in. Nixie, all he needs to do now is not get caught out. Trinket up in about 15 seconds. He'll just sit in stealth until that trinket comes back. Next time he has the stuns, use it on Z-Pi, go for the kill, Looney Oom, Tempo Storm with a clean execution here will finish the game, but we're already at 75% dampening.
Nixie, Looney went for a risky play. He wanted to get Shadow Sight to pull Nixie or Botar out of stealth. Nixie tried to punish it, but he doesn't want to risk throwing the game, so Nixie grappling hooks out of the fight. And dampening at 76%, you can't make a mistake. One stun and you're going to be done. Nixie needs to be careful. He's been the primary kill target throughout this whole game. He trinkets, he trades, he goes blind. He tries to get a kill in this final moment. Z-Pi deflects with Astral Shift. It's a race to the finish at this point. Who's going to fall first, Nixie or Z-Pi? Both of them have basically nothing to work with. Dampening is at the most insane level we've ever seen in the game. Nixie decides to escape. He doesn't want to risk it. He's relying on Alec to carry, but Grounding Totem, Wind Shear, there's too much disruption. Alec can't do enough damage on his own. Botar gets caught in the bash. They switch some attention. He barkskins instantly, but then they switch back to Nixie. The Intimidating Cow can easily close the game. Nixie's gonna fall.
The overlap.
Tempo Storm trying to play for the long game. What is that polymorph? You cannot afford to heal Blizzo back to full. Botar is still low. Of course they're gonna play it out. I mean, at 81% dampening, nobody can heal. Why wouldn't you at least try? But Botar is gonna fall. Tempo Storm loose on their best map.
Tempo Storm really threw at the end of that one. They overlapped the trinket on Botar.
In the previous games where it came down to one global or two globals, maybe they feel like we can just do it a little bit better and actually beat them at this. They obviously believe that they are the better team, so.
Well, let's see if they are, because XRB is within striking distance of winning the final EU Grand Final of the year and heading into BlizzCon with all of the momentum in the world.
Yeah, both these teams have a lot to prove their performances throughout the years. I would say that XRB to the Moon was on an upward trajectory. On the other hand, Tempo Storm has just not been able to get anything done throughout the year. This is the first time we've seen them in the Grand Finals. They look to stay alive in it. They need to reverse sweep 4 games in a row. Can Botar, the returning 2-time BlizzCon champion, be what Tempo Storm needs to do that?
I mean, Botar already got them to their first grand final. That's a fantastic achievement in itself. The acolytes on this guy are absolutely unbelievable. 2-time BlizzCon champion, third last year, but I mean, who won last year? It was Alec and Nixie on this roster. They have everything going for them, but so far, XRB to the Moon, not only have they been a wall for Tempo Storm, they've been a wall for every single team in Europe, especially in Battle for Azeroth. Looney in particular, we've commended him on his fantastic play, and once again, this is Turbo. This is their main composition that they've drafted. They've beaten everyone with it, and Tempo Storm starting to fall behind once again here.
XRB to the Moon are smashing Tempo Storm right now. They've managed to force so many cooldowns. Jimmy needs to get Tremor. He manages to get it. They've got good pressure now on Z-Pi. Looney bounces back with Iron Bark. It's unlikely that he would go down through that, but now Botar doesn't have that option. He gets wind sheared by Z-Pi. Jamie hovering at 50%. Tempo Storm have been going for more cheeky swaps on Looney in this specific matchup, and maybe that's their only way to win, is to catch Looney off guard. Blizzo dips low. Nixie gets disarmed. He's in trouble. Windshear lands. Rally on 10% allows Nixie to stay in the fight a couple seconds longer. Looney moves in for some clutch plays, looking for some cyclones. Gets one on Jamie. He can't support the team now. Looney has been just playing more aggressive than Botar in these matchups. Botar's been playing much more passively, and Looney throughout this series has been the game changer, even though it's only very sparingly. When he does it, it's effective. The entire team at 50% health, XRB to the moon in the driver's seat, looking to clean sweep in the last tournament before the global finals at BlizzCon. This is looking like the team to beat.
I mean, XRB to the moon, second in the first cup. If they could pick up a second first place here, as having obviously won last week as well, that would be about as good as it gets in terms of momentum. Then we would be talking about them and potentially the Ghostu crew as being maybe the teams to beat if Ghostu crew can repeat their feat from last week as well. Looney has been a big part of that.
But
Jamie on the flip side, we know what he could do if Stop Strike. Botar, though, gets the same on the other side. XRB win the race, and they win the grand final.
Ring. Raikou right now being like, No, I can run. I can run.
Outlaw.
I can do it. I can do it again. And that's kind of the big question when we look at the bracket here, because they didn't necessarily have the compositions that would allow them to get as deep in brackets as they traditionally are. I mean, they've won majority of the grand finals that we've watched. They weren't even in this one. You can see Method Black getting taken out by Skill Cap Red in the lower quarterfinals. And honestly, look at the lower semis. That is one that truly did catch my attention, because we got Feed versus the Fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.